Hi everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com and today we are dressing our June weed patch. Now, that's kind of deceptive because it's more than one patch. It's a lot of patches and this is what we are working on today. This is crabgrass. Look at the roots. That's why it does so well. And it shows up every spring, every summer. And so you end up pulling it up every time.
Well, I notice you have just a whole bunch of it in here.
There, it's everywhere, yes. And it gets nice and tall, and then it goes to seed, as you can see on the top. And then not only does it spread by roots, but also by seed. But we're also cleaning up this. Some of you know what it is, some of you may not. This is bindweed. Member of the Morning Glory family.
Would you repeat that, please, for Tim?
Bindweed from the Morning Glory family. This will just bind all of your plants together.
I'm going to go out there and find something, just as an example.
Yes.
Let's go find something. In fact, here's a perfect example over here. Look at this poor little plant.
This is a lily. This is a martagon lily. And it's just all over, and then it's going to try to take over this spirulina. It's getting all over those ferns out there. Eventually, it will try to get on everything and just bind it together.
And unfortunately, here's something we have to remove.
I thought we could leave this
one. Oh, we're going to leave this one? Oh, goody,
yeah,
goody, goody.
Yeah, this is a nice tall one. It's not disturbing anyone. This is one of Rick's favorite. It's mullein. It's very soft. It's almost like lamb's ear. And this stalk will get taller and taller and taller and taller, and it'll have yellow flowers all the way down. It's a very pretty plant, but it too will send those seeds everywhere if I don't cut the stalk off before the seeds get ready to fall.
Well, we tackled another humongous area with 150 more bags of mulch.
The weed patch.
Yes, let's go take a look at it.
Yes. Now it looks lovely. It didn't always look like this. It was terrible. And we'll show you pictures of it. This is where all those beautiful Virginia bluebells were in the early spring. And then it got taken over by crabgrass. And you couldn't even see the plants that you see now because they were hidden by all of the grass. So we came out, we cleaned all of those out that we could get out. Rick put down a double layer of weed barrier, and we put 3 or 4 inches of mulch on top of that. Now we stopped the barrier about where the end of that step is. So this has no weed barrier, but all of that does, because that's where it was so infested with all that crabgrass.
You know, I got tired of this because every year I'd have to come out here and attend this one area with grass.
Right, and it was just terrible.
It just never, I mean, we tried all different things. We tried your spray, that didn't work.
No.
Obviously, digging it out didn't work.
No.
In fact, I think that, if anything, it made it worse.
You thought at one point we would just turn this back into part of the lawn and just put regular grass here and just mow it every time.
I mean, it was really frustrating.
It was terrible. And so this is what we did. But this isn't the only area we did.
Well, let's look at the rest.
Now, another area that was also infested with grass was in front of the pergola here. Again, it was easier to find the plants here because the plants are bigger. But it was total grass mixed in with everything else. Just, we could see the iris because they're nice and tall, but we couldn't see where the little hibiscus are coming up, the little Lunas. This part wasn't too bad, except it had wild violets in here.
Mm.
And you're thinking, well, the state flower of Wisconsin is violets.
Well, that entire area back yes. here was covered with wild violets.
Right.
That too still? Well, that's lungwort.
Right. So wild violets are just invasive. They get everywhere. And to me, they're not that pretty. I prefer the dogtooth violets. But we
the
went
dog
in here.
Who?
Dogtooth.
Oh, I thought.
Dogtooth violets.
That's not what it sounded like.
So we put just mulch down here. We didn't put any weed barrier here, but we cleaned up what's here, put down the mulch, and then cleaned this all up, put down the mulch, and it looks so much better. It just looks organized
well,
and
cared for. Well, not only that, but I mean, you can actually see the plants you want to see.
Yes.
That grass was amazing. I mean, let's go over to the trailer once, because this is just part of it. I mean, we haven't even really started, and already we have probably, I know you cut a few daisies out and
right.
some of your bleeding hearts.
Right.
But, I mean, this trailer is what did
four
I say?
By
a 4x8x5.
Mm-hmm.
And it's already half full, more than
well,
half
look.
Full.
Look who's trying to escape and reseed itself.
Yeah, it is.
Muriel.
Good, thank you.
Back in there.
Oh, what
and
a mess.
And the other area we addressed was in front of the front porch.
Well, we also did the side.
Oh, yeah,
too,
we did. Yeah,
as long as we're over
that.
Here.
Yep. You can see where the poppy, the orange poppy is. All of this had to be addressed. Now, in here, I have been able to keep that fairly well rid of things. But again, if you don't keep after it, it'll show up everywhere. So we got foxglove here. We have lilies that are about to open. We have alliums that are now in the next stage of going to seed. You can see our cactus over there. Yes, Wisconsin
it's actually,
has cactus.
It's doing quite well.
They're doing very well. Because, you know, I took down the stuff that was shading it.
Hmm.
We
I'm
had all that garlic
in on
there.
It's just
okay. Those are the, what are they called? They have yellow flowers. Now, I still have not seen flowers on ours, but they do flower. And I think I might see some blossoms starting there. Maybe you should go in a little closer.
I think those are honeysuckle
oh.
droppings, little petal droppings.
No. Look.
Oh, no, I do see, yeah.
Yeah, there is still some grass in
so
there.
So you may have blossoms this
I
year.
I think we will. Well, here's some and there's some. Look at that. Woo-hoo. I think we will get blossoms. Prickly pear. That's what
prickly
it is.
Pear.
Prickly pear.
Is that edible?
I think they do eat that, but I'm not sure. Don't do it until
okay.
you look it up. Now, here is a mystery bush. We don't know what this is. We planted it, then it died, looked like it died, and then it came back. And we think it might be a dogwood, but we're not sure.
You know what I think it is some type of a crab apple tree. It has that similar leaf structure.
I don't know. Possibly.
Hmm. Well.
But it does get tall.
Very tall.
Taller. And this is obviously one of our honeysuckles.
Yeah, this is just full of them.
This one we have to keep control of because it does like to get up over the pergola. It likes to go and get wound up in the lights. And it tries to take over, but it's very pretty. And the hummingbirds love it. The bees and the butterflies love it. So we're not going to take it out. We'll just keep it trimmed.
Oh, before we go this area, the saddest thing was
yeah.
the state of this
Korean maple.
Korean maple.
Right.
I don't know
year,
if it didn't get enough water.
Yeah, last year was very hard on it, and possibly we didn't. this whole tree is gone, but it's coming up from the base. So we will just nurture it, and hopefully at some point we'll get another beautiful little, it's a shorter maple and more bushy.
And how about all the hostas that are in the sun?
Well,
I mean, these are big.
There used to be trees here.
Yes.
And they just haven't adjusted, I guess. They just keep coming back.
Amazing.
Maybe there's enough shade from the pergola.
Oh, that could be.
It keeps them, you know. And then we have more lilies. These are the peonies we thought were never going to come up. We planted them a year ago. One came up from the roots. We didn't give up. We had the rings there, and sure enough, three more came back.
Yep, they all made it.
So don't give up on your plants if they don't show up.
And I just put some Montauk daisies over here, and I cut them back, and I'm
amazed. You cut them very well back.
Yeah, and I'm amazed that they're doing quite well. Even over here, I mean, they look terrible now, but...
Oh, they'll be fine.
They'll be fine once they get their little feet going.
And this is our shaded area. This has probably the most shade, except for right under the maple tree. This is one of our newest coral bells. But these are stilbes, which like partial shade, and coral bells, which are absolutely gorgeous. Just like them a lot.
Nice job.
Thank you.
That only took us 3 days.
Hey, well, then we did in front of the porch. Remember
that? Oh, that's
true. So that adds into the 3 days.
Yes.
We were blessed over the weekend to receive almost a half an inch of rain.
Whoopee!
We have had no rain since early May, and the grass really took a beating. This actually looks good compared to what it was.
I mean, this entire area was yellow.
Yes.
And I didn't cut it that short.
No. Nope. So in the front, we had all those giant bleeding hearts, which I have now cut way back. If I don't cut them way back, a gazillion seeds would fall everywhere. Plus, eventually, they just kind of die back anyway, and they look awful. So if I move them there, take them down, then the hostas can get some sun. The alliums, the big alliums, can be beautiful. They look like purple clouds coming along here. So then we also continued with the mulch, just to make it look pretty.
Well, you had the Girl Scouts here yesterday.
Yes, we did.
And you're going to have the Elm
Grove Women's Garden Club is coming at the end of the month.
Oh.
So we want things to look nice.
Yeah.
One flower I think we should show is the yarrow, because it's looking so pretty. I just have to show it.
Well, you were concerned that it wasn't yellow.
Right. It came out, and I had forgotten when it first starts, it all looks white. And I'm thinking, oh no, don't tell me it changed colors. But it didn't. So we have yellow. This was our original plant. I've moved it to two other places. And then we also have pink. It's very pretty. And this is the newer form of yarrow that doesn't spread everywhere.
Nice.
If you enjoyed this video, because we have more work to do, we have to get busy, please give us a thumbs up. We truly appreciate that. And if you'd like to leave a comment or questions, we would be happy to hear from you. If you're not a subscriber and you'd like to be, we would love for you to put your little click on that subscribe button, and then you'll see a little bell up here that will tell you if we have a new video. And if ever you want to see more of our videos, you can go to wisconsingarden.com, and you can follow me as Richard does and see many of the other videos we've
got. I'll follow you to the ends of the earth.
Thank you, honey.
As long as I get a Spreckers.
You will. You had one today.
I know. Thank you.
And it's not even hot out.
I know. What a treat.
Yes. Bye for now.
Connect with us on YouTube.